It'll be interesting to see who may show up. It is my secret stream. So today, I'm going to be coloring the drawing that I did yesterday. I'm going to do it as a quickie. Give this a few minutes to all start showing up and we'll get started here. So just a minute. We're almost going here. Okay, I don't think anybody is watching. This is my secret stream. All right, folks. So, this is the drawing from yesterday. I scanned it and made it into line art, and we're just going to get started on it. If anybody here discovers me, chat and let me know you're here. My unannounced coloring stream. So, the first thing I need to do let's make it grayscale and we'll unlock it and call it that'll be 400 dpi. Okay. Okay. Yeah, that's good. I'll give it a bunch of layers. Boy, five people are watching already. You guys just discovered me. There's all those layers. I put the black layer at the top. And I will select the white. This, of course, is Ted Cruz, Donald Trump and Marco Rubio. They've got a debate tonight, and they're the three front runners, and they're all attacking each other and kind of nasty, so it's just them tongue-tied and looking kind of nasty. Basically all there is to this one. I'm planning on drawing another live stream cartoon tomorrow, and that'll be Flint, Michigan water cartoon. That one I'll announce on social media because I'll be sitting here for a whole lot of hours. All right, let's make sure that's white. And that's CMYK. Don't merge. Select all. Oh, wait for it to be CMYK. And thank you folks who are here for watching. I did put up the pop-up on Cagle.com, so that may be how you found me. If you would, please follow my stream on Twitch. I would really appreciate that. I'm low on followers. I need the following. So here, I'm going to make sure that's white again. Let's select color range and delete it. Then here, I will lay in the white. Now I've got all these nice intermediate layers to put colors in. All right. Next, check the black. See how the black is all this garbage of CMY and K? That will not do. So let's change that to 100 black. And go to this layer and make it multiply. That makes the color show up behind it. We'll select all. Select color range. I'm going to delete because sometimes it wants to look. This is going to be one of those situations where it wants to resist doing what I tell it to do. Not quite sure why Photoshop wants to do that. I'm going to fill with my black 100%. I think it's resisting. Let's see how clean that is. Pick that. 93%. See, why does it do that? Sometimes it resists. So I'm going to fill a few more times, get it up close to 100. I think Photoshop doth protest too much. Wait for it to think. Taking a good deal of time thinking, isn't it? Oh, it's nice to see a few people on here watching. Nice to know I just jump in and stream anytime and somebody comes and watches. That's kind of fun. But you guys are not very chatty. So what is Photoshop thinking about here? Photoshop giving me some trouble. Let's come back and select the black and see what we got it up to. 92 still. 100 fill. Oh, that looks like it took. Still 100. 99. Just really wants to resist that last little bit. It fights for every little bit of not making it black, doesn't it? Bill. Oh, wait, did I make that 99? Nope, that's good. Bill. Fill, 100% black, 100% fill. All right, you think that's going to be 100% black? Let's take a look. Stinking fighting Photoshop. Oh, there we got 100% black. Finally. It's like having a toddler that doesn't want to eat its vegetables. All right. Now I need to consider. Oh no, now I need to change it to 400 dpi. Let it resize. Give it a minute here. Alright. That should be good. And so what'll happen here is the finest lines will gray out, but I'll be getting it looking like it's an ink drawing, and that's all good. Okay. I took a scan of the comics in the newspaper the other day because it was very poorly printed, and it made a point that I wanted to make on here about why I do all of this stuff the way I do it. So, this is the bad newspaper printing that I have to anticipate all the time. Jumpstart and Nine Chickweed Lane were a couple of good examples by under the fair use provision of the copyright law. I am presenting these two images in the context of a review to say that their printing and their preparation is really pretty lousy. So what happens here is, like here on Jumpstart, underneath all the black lines, there is no color. So when the blue, magenta, and yellow are printed a little bit off, you get all of that no color under the black lines showing as these halos. So you always want your color to run underneath your black lines so that when things are out of sync, you're not getting the white halos. It still looks bad when it's not in register, but it won't look like that. Nine Chickweed Lane has another problem. Look at all this junk going on. What's happening here is that the black isn't 100% black. It's black plus a percentage of yellow and a percentage of cyan and a percentage of magenta. And that makes for a bunch of crap when it's printed out of register. And you get the black lines breaking up and gumming up. Here you can see very clearly that magenta's farther to the left, cyan in the middle, and yellow the least out of register. Everything is out of register in this thing. This is the nature of newspapers. Newspaper printing just sucks. So the way to deal with it, this is you do what I just did. You put your black alone on the K channel, and that way you're not having the CMYK to do all of this baloney. And at least that way you can read the lettering when it's in terrible registration. So this is my terrible registration example. The two issues that we deal with by the way that I just prepped the image to put the black lines on the top layer as 100% K, 0% CMY, so that I'm not going to get either of these bad registration problems. Interesting to see these two examples on the comic strip page right next to each other in the LA Times, huh? Alright, so back to the job at hand. I have to decide what colors I want to make this. And right now I'm thinking maybe this needs to have a yellow background. Yellow background is going to de-emphasize Trump's yellow hair. But, what the hell. Hey, you folks that are watching this, please do follow me. Even though you are silent and don't want to chat, I really would appreciate you following me. So, please, please, costs nothing. It's a very nice thing to do. Follow me. All right, I'm going to start on the background farthest back. Let's lay in some yellow. What do we got here? How about 10 magenta and 70 yellow? That looks kind of nice. We'll bump up the diameter here. Just give this a bunch of yellow. I like yellow because you can have a nice strong color without losing your contrast with the black lines, and I'm always doing the black line stuff because you know, the nature of editorial cartoons plus the nature of how I draw. You silent folks. I didn't announce this on social media, so I'm here by surprise. Okay, it's looking kind of yellow. I'm going to put some of my sponge texture in it. This is a texture that I made for myself, just because I like a spongy texture. And I did it by scanning an actual sponge. Put ink on a sponge, and this is what I got. And then I saved a palette of a few colors that I usually use for sponge. I like the rubber stamp tool, which is what I use for my sponge. Okay, let's put a little bit of yellow in here to brighten up some bits. Alright, that looks a little kind of little appropriately nasty to the nasty stuff we got going on here. I'm looking at the stream. Boy, the stream is running like 2 minutes behind on Twitch. My goodness. Maybe 3 minutes. Alright, let's go to the pink tongue. That looks kind of nice. Make it 20. How's that for tongue? Okay. Here I shall. Well, do I want to do that? Yeah, I think I need to make it hard and opaque. Just so that it's a little easier to draw into all these spaces. So let's do that. Oops. On the wrong layer. So that multiply choice for the black layer at the top, that makes everything underneath it show through. It makes all the colors underneath it print. Unlike that comic strip example that I gave you, where underneath the black lines it was white, multiply lets everything underneath it print, which is what you need for all your cartoons and all the lousy newspaper printing. You silent folks that are watching this. You know, I do chat. It would be nice if you folks had something to say. I think these tongues are kind of nasty. That was part of what I was going for here, is a little bit of a air of nasty. Nasty's good. Well, in some context, nasty is good. I should not make so sweeping a statement that I might later regret. Daryl, you said nasty was good. No, nasty is often not good. Not to misquote me. You know, if you guys are not going to leave any chat messages, you might find that I go silent. It isn't the natural course of things for me to mumble to myself all the time. Tongues. Boy, Twitch is running far behind. Twitch frozen? No. Running? It's just running far behind. So if you do send a chat note, keep in mind that I'm about probably 3 or 4 minutes ahead of you. So be patient for my response, because you're not going to hear it for 3 or 4 minutes. Although that doesn't seem to be a problem right now. I'm going to do a little bit of modeling on these tongues before I get rid of them. Let's go on the next layer. Let's do a bit of darker tongue. That'll be soft and smaller. And opacity, let's say 33. Is that what I want? 33? No, that's not enough. Go with 57. How's that? Oh, that's pretty dark. Alright, this is the first bit of shade. Note that the light source is at the top, shining down. So I want the light to show up at the bottoms of the tongues. Okay. Let's go for a little bit darker in the darker spots. Do remember to follow me. I would much appreciate that. No people have followed today. I think I may be falling on deaf ears. Okay. Found a couple of little holidays there. All right, that's got a little bit of modeling. Let's go for some texture. So on the next layer, I'm going to give it a little bit of sponge nasty. Sponge nasty is fun. 40%. All right, 40%. What do you think of that? That looks kind of nasty tonguey, doesn't it? Yeah. This is the shine on the textural tongue. Popping back to give a few spots some extra shine. I think these tongues are looking pretty nasty. Are they believable? Well, let's see. I can add a little bit of red. That should go in pretty light. Let's make that 15%. And let's just give little bits of tongue warmth here in the yellowy red. Is it a little more sense of depth? Putting a little more warmth into the shadows. I think those are looking pretty nasty tonguey. Nasty and tonguey. All right, let's bring that down and put in the flesh tone. So the flesh tone will be up here on number 7. Go for 3, 22, 22. How's that look? And let's make that 82%. Pump this guy up. So people are watching, silently watching. Oh, you know, I think I want that to go behind the tongue so that I don't have to worry about edges of the tongues, so I'm going to do that. That way I can just draw over the tongues and not have to worry. I'll come back and clean up the edges here. If another little trick, if you have a background color, when you put in stuff like flesh tones on top of the background color, if you don't make it 100% and you let some of that background color show through, you get a little bit of sense of everything living in the same world. It looks like it belongs. And I think people would not be able to look at it and say why it belongs, but it will make it look like it belongs. Honest. Okay. Now I can give them a little bit darker flesh. Let's go with 4, 33, 33. Up that back a little bit and just put in a little bit of modeling. I don't like to do a lot of modeling in the flesh tones because probably should have done this on another layer. Let's do add another layer there. And this is basically the way you watercolor, put the colors in light and come back and darken them up with the next round. Okay, let's go a little darker. I'm gonna put in another layer for that in case I don't like it. So these guys are going to be on the debate tonight, arguing. But this cartoon cannot be printed until Tuesday, because the newspapers are closed for the weekend. They've already put their made their cartoon choices on Friday for Sunday. So they'll see this Monday morning, and then they'll decide if they want to print it. Has a wonderful face. Wonderful face. I don't like Cruz, but I could see drawing him for 4 years. Hopefully not 8 years. Nobody I want to draw for 8 years. Right, I'm gonna grab a bit of that light flesh, bump that up, bump that down, see if I can smooth out the Donald's looking a little bit not sophisticated enough. Okay, now they need a little bit of pink. I'm gonna pink them up just a bit. So let's go 0, 36, so 36, how about 40? I'm gonna put that up here. Layer 5. Bump that up, opacity, let's call it 15. A little bit of pink under cheeks. Give them a bit of life and color. Color on his lips. Give a bit of life in his cheek. Same for Rubio. Rubio might have a little bit of a red nose. A little bit of lip. A little bit of extra pink just gives a little bit of life to these guys. Pinks up the nose a little bit. Alright, that's probably about all the flesh tone I want to give him. Alright, I think they're there. Now, do I want to give them a little bit of, let's give them their dark hair. I suppose they both have brown eyes, huh? I can do that. Looks like a good brown. I haven't confirmed that they have brown eyes, but what the hell? Whiten up the teeth. Eyeball and his eyeball. Even when an eyeball is in shade, I make it white. Oh, Hamstripe too. You're my first comment. My goodness, I've been talking here for 37 minutes with nobody commenting. That is some nightmare fuel. It is. Nice to see you here, Hamstripe. Okay. You can watch my last video and you can see me drawing this one. Thanks for the comments, Hamstripe. All right, the Donald's hair needs to come up a bit. Do that. And another layer. Does that all completely need to come out? Give him a bit of that. Hellward 69, nice to see you here. If you haven't followed already, please, please do follow. Alright, Donald's hair. Donald's hair is interesting because he's just got gray hair. He doesn't really have orange hair in the sense that he's a redhead. He's got orange hair in the sense that, you know, some people with gray hair don't get white hair. They get kind of orange hair. That's why the ladies put the blue in their hair and they end up with all these blue-haired ladies. Well, Donald is the equivalent of one of those blue-haired ladies who has not dealt with his orange hair. So, that makes it interesting to me. I'm going to go with some a little bit of very light orange. Let's make it 15. Put it on layer 10. A little bit of Donald orange-esque texture in his hair. I think I'd probably put a little more yellow into it too. I was concerned about the background being yellow, drowning out the Donald's hair. Yes, the hair has a life of its own, Hellward. But the hair is funny, and you gotta catch the character of it. I think it's kind of blending with the background. Maybe that's okay. Let me give it some 100%. Texture for the sponge. Kind of funny. Give him a little bit more taste of orange, just a taste of orange down here at the base. The hair is really pretty wispy. It's kind of like a little cloud in front of his forehead. So now I think I'm going to need a tiny bit of shadow under his little hair cloud. We'll do that. Hair cloud shadow. 12%? Alright, 12% for his hair cloud shadow. Gentlemen, please do subscribe. I mean, please do follow. Appreciate the follows. Okay. I'm not sure I want to have more detail than that. Get Cruz's teeth white. Opacity 100. I think I could do a little bit of inside the mouth pink. Let's do that. That looks okay. All right. I don't want to have too much craziness going on with the color. Otherwise, otherwise it's just paying too much attention to everything. Okay, let's come up here, and I'm just going to clean up my edges with some white. Hamstride writes, hee hee, I would, but I already followed the other day. My apologies. Oh, well, thank you, Hamstripe. I appreciate it. That's probably how you found my stream, huh? When I started, did it give you an announcement because you're a follower that I'm starting? Does that happen automatically? I think it does. Still new to all of this. You know, this live streaming on Twitch is really pretty complicated. I haven't figured out some things like when the announcements go out. I want to start being nice and hosting other people's streams when I quit, and haven't quite figured that out either. But I like that tradition. That seems friendly. So you know, keep in mind when I don't do some of these things, it's only out of ignorance. I'm getting caught up. It just takes a while. So I appreciate your commenting so that I'm not left talking into the void to no one. Oh, that's very nice. Hamstripe writes, streamers you followed show up on the right-hand side so you can go to their channels when they're online. That's really very nice. Okay. Am I happy with this? What different does it need? Is that enough? Check some of my remember where I was on these layers. All right, that's the layer where I went out of the lines with Rubio's flesh tone. I'll clean that up. I think that's kind of looking okay. L-word, so you're having dinner while you watch, huh? Okay. So tomorrow I'm going to draw Flint, Michigan. Do I want to put a little dark into the border? Maybe I do. That might be kind of interesting. How about a brown? That hard and small. -34% is the problem. Tuna noodle casserole with mushroom sauce. My goodness. While you watch these tongues, I can see why the tongues would be disturbing. Watching this while you eat tuna casserole. Ew. Never had a casserole before. That's pretty odd, Hamstripe. America is the land of casseroles. It's just nice to give this border a little sense that it's more a part of the art. So I'm putting a little brown in the border goofiness. But frankly, I think I'm kind of overworking because I'm probably about where I need to be with this. So this is going to be the color version that I save. Now I'm going to take a look at what it looks like in grayscale, because I have to deliver grayscale to the newspapers that print gray. Otherwise they'll just gray my color version, and sometimes that looks lousy. So what it looks like in grayscale. Don't merge. Okay. Well, that is not looking good in grayscale, is it? Because it's flattening out these characters with the background. So what do I want to do here? I think I'm going to need to give the background more color and take some color out of the flesh tone. So let's do that. For the gray version, I need to take some color out of the flesh tones. And it is such that you always have to come in and do something to the gray version, because right. Bring that down. I can keep Cruz dark up there. Rubio some more contrast. Didn't need it in the color. But does need it in the gray. could make the background much darker. Might play with that. Or I might just put more texture in the background. That seems like a more likely solution to me. Let's try that. Got a new layer down there. Let's go up to the gray tool. Let's see what it looks like to add some more. That's too dark. So a little bit of texture is going to differentiate it from the flat tones in front of it. That's kind of fun. Hamstrite writes, if you were to make the background extremely dark, you would have more issues with hair. What paint program are you using? I'm using Photoshop CS4. It's an oldie, but I have never had reason to upgrade. And you're right, if I made it back, I would made it very dark in the background, I think it would be less interesting. Would make everything pop, but it needs a little more complexity than that. You know, I might even just up here on the top put some, think about this for a minute. Did I use that layer? No. I might put some white texture on everything. Trump a little. Is that looking okay? No. Dark. I mean too opaque. Just a little hint of texture is what they need. So it kind of looks like I've got a piece of paper going. Hint of texture, gentlemen. Hints of texture. So you're not even going to notice it, but the texture is going to flatten. Kind of looking forward to the debate tonight. These guys should be plenty grouchy. Trump should be back on stage. Do I need to lighten his hair up because it's matching the background? Put some of that texture into lighten Rubio up a bit more too. That's better. Let's try a little bit of new layer there so I know it's blank. Go to that. Do some white. Well, it needed that futzen for black and white, but I think I'm done with this. That's the black and white version. Save it. And now I will flatten. Okay, and save as. can see how full of junk my hard disk is. Date modified. This will be cartoon number 1090. That means since I started changing my naming convention for these cartoons, I've drawn 1,090 editorial cartoons. Since I started doing the numbers instead of just names. All right, let's go back to open the color version. So yes, I draw a lot of editorial cartoons. Tongue-tied. CMYK. We will save this one as... Perhaps I shouldn't do this kind of stuff on the video. Now, typically, that's going to be kind of big, so I'm going to save as a JPEG at 9 quality, because that will surely not be too big. I need to have the files not exceed 3.5 megabytes, but that won't. And neither will the TIFF for the gray. So I think I'm good. That is that. Thank you for joining me, Hamstripe and Hillward. And I'm going to pop back online tomorrow and draw an all-new cartoon about Flint, Michigan. In fact, if you want to see it, this is my rough sketch for the cartoon. This is the elephant... pooping, and the plumbing brings the glass of water to the little black girl from Flint. So, thank you so much. I'm all finished here. Please drop back. Oh, hello, Vivi Corsi. And this cartoon is done. Join me tomorrow for a new cartoon. And thank you so much.